Nebraska Cornhusker fans begin every season hoping all roads will lead to Omaha. Their 2001 and 2002 trips to the College World Series helped to transform a low-profile program into one of the toughest tickets in the country. And today, the Big Red Nation is gathered again to see the Huskers face Miami one win away from making the 50-mile trip down I-80 again to college baseball's paradise. Third seed in Nebraska against Miami, 3-1 losers yesterday in the first game, so the Hurricanes must win today and tomorrow to make another trip for Miami to Omaha. Dave Barnett along with Frank Viola, Hawks Field at Haymarket Park. Miami stakes its hopes today on a 6'2 senior from Cooper City, Florida, Brandon Camerdis, who is not that far removed from a case of the mumps, not something most college athletes or even college students have to deal with, but it knocked him out for a good portion of the latter end of the season, and after being sent home for 10 days to make sure he didn't infect any of his teammates, he was back in action for the ACC tournament, but has been very limited, and in fact, in the last 34 days, Frank has totaled 7 innings pitched. So whatever they get out of him, I think in the way of a long outing beyond 5-6 innings will be a pleasant surprise for Jim Morris.
No question. And his longest outing of the year, even when healthy, has been 6 innings. So the key for Camerdis is to establish a strike zone, get the ball in play with the least amount of pitches necessary, and give him the longest outing he could possibly give. The biggest question on the Miami coaching staff's behalf on his is the stamina issue, as you mentioned. He is 6-0. He has all 4 pitches that lefties have, fast curve, slider, change. The big key for him is being able to throw those pitches at any time for strikes.
Nebraska, the visiting team today. And again, leading off is the left fielder Jesse Boyer, senior Littleton, Colorado product, 283 average. Brandon Camerdis has not lost this year. He's 6-0, and the first pitch fouled away. This is his 13th start. ERA is a bit high, 5.17. Opponent average is 2.72. He has been their number 2 starter behind ace Cesar Carrillo pretty much all season, except for when he came down with the mumps. But the Huskers beat Carrillo yesterday behind Jabba Chamberlain's 13-strikeout, 8-inning masterpiece. And one of the top offenses in the country was, with the exception of a solo home run by Paco Figueroa, erased that one right through the coach's box down to third. A ball and 2 strikes. That was a little too close.
And Coach Anderson, being a typical ex-pitcher, thinking he can make the play. I think he had second thoughts here at the last second and got out of the way, fortunately. Very important for Camerdis right now to shut Nebraska out in the first inning, give him a chance to get on the board first.
Called strike 3, and Camerdis begins the game, getting Jesse Boyer to look at strike 3 on the inside corner. Rest of the Nebraska lineup, brought to you by Sonic. We'll now see the shortstop, Joe Simakaitis. And then their star, Alex Gordon, number 2 overall pick in the draft by Kansas City. Curtis Ledbetter again hitting cleanup. Andy Gertsch again in right field. Daniel Bruce and Ryan Bohannon have changed places from yesterday's lineup. That's the only change. Ryan Worley still at second, batting 8th, and the catcher, Jeff Christie, who had a major contribution yesterday, out of the 9 spot. So here's Simakaitis. First pitch, lined for a base hit to left center field. Two hits yesterday, a strikeout and a sacrifice, and Simakaitis continues a hot super regional. The Miami defense behind Camerdis. Figueroa brothers in their usual spots. The identical twins, Danny and Paco. No changes for Jim Morris. Valencia at first, Paco at second, Walter Diaz shortstop, Ryan Braun, the 5th overall pick in the draft by the Brewers, again down at third. So here's Alex Gordon. We have 2 of the top 5 picks in the draft, both third basemen, neither of whom had much of a day yesterday. Alex 0-for-3 with a walk. And Ryan Braun 0-for-4. This one is driven deep and gone. And Alex Gordon gives the Huskers a 2-0 lead. Number 19 on the year for Alex Gordon.
That's why you're an All-American right there. That's why you're the team leader. That's how you make things happen. First inning, as a visiting team, you got to come out of the gate quick. Hamadiz kept the fastball up out of the zone, and Gordon, as he's done all year, took advantage of that pitch and drove it to left center field for the home run.
Sixty-fourth runs batted in on the season, and Ledbetter goes after the first pitch.
The problem you have is when he was pitching to Jesse Boyd to start the ball game off, he had strike two and struck him out on fastballs inside. What he tried doing right there with another lefty at the plate, and Gordon, was he was trying to establish inside and off the plate. What he did was he left that pitch up on the plate, and Gordon, being the great hitter he is, just took advantage of that.
Ledbetter, first baseman, cleanup hitter. 1-1 pitch. Looked out of the zone, it's 1-2.
Important for Camadis right now to regroup, regain his composure. It's a 2-0 ball game. At this ballpark, it's not that difficult to overcome. It's a small ballpark, right center field, left center field. Gaps are hitter's gaps. Get it back together and get this guy out.
Pop up right side of the infield, second baseman Paco Figueroa. Out number two. Well, the Hurricanes really have known nothing other than this feeling. Trying to fight not only the 8,500 packing Hawks Field again, fighting maybe the hottest team in the tournament. Nebraska has won their last 9 since they lost the opener of the Big 12 tournament to Texas Tech. 4 of those elimination games in that Big 12 tournament. And they finally beat Baylor in the championship game 1-0. Swept through the regional here against Illinois, Chicago, and Creighton. And after beating the Hurricanes by 2 yesterday, they're up 2 here. Gertz drives this one deep and off the wall in left center field. And Andy Gertz with the 2-out double.
Biggest problem you're going to see with Camadis today is after that bump layoff in 2 weeks, 3 weeks, it's just not only the stamina issue, but location. When you miss that much time, it is very tough to come back, get the velocity and location working together. Right there, Rodriguez was sitting in off the plate looking for a fastball inside, and once again, Camadis left it out over the plate, gave Gertz a chance to extend his hands and drive that ball left center field. Camadis has got to be able to start mixing and matching and hitting his spots.
Now the center fielder, Daniel Bruce. This is the 32nd game this year in which Nebraska has scored in the first inning. Daniel Bruce at 313. A solo home run yesterday. A strikeout. And a ground out, a senior from Omaha who hopes to end his career in Omaha. Millard West High School there. One of the best student athletes in college baseball. Who has been awarded a Big 12 postgraduate scholarship. Second team academic All-America. With an almost 3.9 grade point average in English, 3.86. The Nebraska Male Student Athlete of the Year for 2005. Three hits here in the inning. A single by Simakaitis, followed by the homer by Gordon. One out later, Andy Gertz with the double. And 1-2 now to Bruce.
So far, this whole at-bat was set up by the first pitch changeup by Cameron Deese, and he's been able to throw the fastball by him. But in the back of his mind, I would think that Bruce is thinking something off speed.
missed away. Thinking right along with you, 2-2.
Yep. Now he's in the spot where he's just gone 3 fastballs away. I'd still go after him with the fastball just for the fact that he hasn't shown me that he's been on it. I think he's going to speed up the bat with a changeup. That would be a bad pitch. Right now, if I'm thinking along the same lines as pitching coach JD, go with the fastball.
Out of play. Yesterday, Daniel Bruce in the 5th inning with the tie-breaking solo shot. Put the Huskers up 2-1. Turned out to be the game winner in a 3-1 victory. Bruce again waiting for the 2-2 pitch. The Hurricanes will have to go after one of the top freshman pitchers in the country. Johnny Dorn starts for Nebraska today, 11-1. Freshman All-America. Already in a hole, 2-0. And another one driven foul through Anderson, who draws the boos to the third base box. Minute ago, diving for his life. Now he can't handle the routine play.
A little too easy for him. A little too easy.
Yesterday's hero, Jabba Chamberlain. 8 innings, 13 strikeouts.
Must be 2-2 and 2 outs.
Johnny Dorn waiting for his turn today. Extend the at-bat by Bruce.
Daniel Bruce is doing a couple of things positive right here. Number one, he's seeing all the pitches Cammadees has, but the other thing is making them work. And the more pitches Cammadees has to throw early in the ball game, it's going to hurt him as the game progresses. As we mentioned, his stamina is not back to where he needs it to be. And you want to get into Miami's bullpen right now. So the more you make him work early, the tougher it's going to be for him later on in the game.
They've made him work. This is the 20th pitch coming here in the first inning. And another 2-2, which bounces in. Eddie Rodriguez prevents Gertz from advancing. 3-2 to Bruce.
As I mentioned, what you've seen so far, 2-seam fastball, you've seen a 4-seam fastball, you've seen a curveball, you've seen a changeup, you've seen pretty much everything Cammadees has to offer. Right now, a 3-2 pitch, first base open, lefty on deck. I don't know if they think that much in the college game, but it wouldn't surprise me if he goes with something off speed right here, pitching backwards a little bit.
Decent strikeout ratio during the year, 42 and 55 2/3 coming in. That one under the zone. Bruce waves at it. 2 strikeouts in the first inning, but a 2-run home run by the Husker star, the Big 12 player of the year, Alex Gordon. And Nebraska off to a 2-0 lead. Miami coming to bat in Lincoln. Morris, a fixture in the Super Regional round. 9 of the last 11 years has taken the Hurricanes to the College World Series. Tough start today, though, down 2-0. And his Sonics starting lineup. Looks like yesterday with Danny Figueroa leading off in center, his twin brother Paco batting second at second, and then Ryan Braun At third, batting third, John Jay, left fielder, hits cleanup. Danny Valencia at first, Brandon Caton in right, Eddie Rodriguez catches, Roger Tomas is the DH, and hitting ninth is the shortstop, Walter Diaz. And the freshman All-America, third-team All-America, out of Grand Island, Nebraska, 6'3", 205-pound Johnny Dorn.
How about this for a second number two starter, 11-1, 2.02 earned run average. He is what Coach Anderson says, a quiet competitor. He doesn't say much, just goes out and lets his pitching do his talking. He's got four pitches as well. He just throws them all at any time. He's going to be fun to watch.
And the first pitch for the second baseman, Ryan Worley, to retire Danny Figueroa. 0-for-4 with three strikeouts yesterday. And during the year, a reliable leadoff hitter to ignite the Miami offense. So far, Husker pitchers have prevented Danny Figueroa from becoming a factor.
Getting back to Dorn for a second, the big number that sticks out in my mind, watch, look at his stats, is his 192 batting average against. That tells me his kid's not afraid, just like Jabba yesterday, goes right after the hitters. Coach Childress's idea and thought process is pitchers go right after the hitters, let your defense play for you. And I'll tell you why, it's been successful all year for Nebraska.
Here's Paco. Older by 4 minutes than his identical twin, Danny. Paco is a senior. Danny is just a junior redshirt because Danny missed last year after elbow and shoulder surgeries. So Paco winding up his career, second team All-ACC. Career year in nine different categories this year. They were both drafted by the Orioles. Ninth round for Paco. Just on the outside corner at the knees, and a ball and two strikes.
A couple real nice sliders back to back right there. Location, location, location. That's the name of the game, and that's Johnny Dorn's game.
After low and away, tries to come back in on the fists, and it's 2-2.
Now it sets up anything he wants to do right there. Two sliders away, comes in with a fastball in off the plate. He can go back with a fastball in, or he can go back stuff away with breaking stuff.
A little lazy bloop into shallow center field for Daniel Bruce. Behind Dorn today, the same group that backed up Jabba Chamberlain yesterday. Jeff Christie, 2-for-2 in cutting down Hurricane base stealers yesterday, and is now 6-for-7 in the postseason.
And he dictated a whole bunch of the game yesterday, specifically defensively, because he took Miami early on out of their running game by throwing those two guys out.
Well, after his struggles yesterday, Alex Gordon has already shown this is going to be a different afternoon. Now up to Ryan Braun to see if he can follow suit. The junior from Granada Hills, California, picked Miami over Stanford. Fifth overall in the draft by the Brewers. 0-for-4 yesterday. And the average at .389, 18 home runs. The only Hurricane at double figures. 75 driven in, which leads this lineup by 12. So no way to overemphasize how important Braun is to the offense. And when he was controlled yesterday, his teammates were unable to pick up for him.
No question. And that's important. As you mentioned earlier, Gordon getting off as he did today with that home run, it's important for Ryan Braun to show his teammates, let's go.
3-2.
Johnny Dorn, 3-1 slider right there. On the outside corner, painting the corner.
ACC Player of the Year, finalist for the Golden Spikes. And the 3-2 pitch is just low. He tried to come back with a fastball at the same spot, and Braun is aboard for the first time in this Super Regional. Don't expect many of those because yesterday Chamberlain and Brett Jensen did not walk a batter, and Dorn during the year walked only 19 in his 18 appearances. John Jay, 2-for-4 yesterday. And at 4-11, top average Dorn will face, the sophomore from Miami, as are so many of the Hurricanes. Christopher Columbus High School, All-State for a 6A state champion there. Here goes Braun, and Christie's throw this time bounces in, and for just the second time in the entire NCAA tournament, somebody steals off Jeff Christie.
By that time, that was stolen totally on Johnny Dorn right there. He held the ball. He altered his look a little bit at first base, but he held it, but his high leg kick, and Braun just got a great jump. Christie had no chance right there. We have to also mention that Ryan Braun has 22 stolen bases. That was his 23rd stolen base on the year, so he not only has some power, but he's got some speed as well.
Two and one, John Jay, fourth all-time batting average. Pat Burrell, still first all-time Miami history. And he loops this one to shallow center field, but the shortstop Simakaitis is there. A walk, a stolen base by Ryan Braun. But again, Miami fails to score against airtight Nebraska pitching. 2-0 after one.
The U.S. Open, America's championship in the most demanding test in golf. Masters champion Tiger Woods takes aim at his second major of the year, while Phil Mickelson, Vijay Singh, and Ernie Els battle the sandhills of legendary Pinehurst. The game's greatest players push to the limit in pursuit of one of golf's most prestigious prizes, the 150th U.S. Open. Live coverage begins Thursday at 10 a.m. Eastern on ESPN.
I'll tell you what, Pete. Some days, a Sonic breakfast burrito is the only thing that gets me out of bed.
Yeah, well, I mean, it can't be the only thing. It's got to be other things to get you out of bed.
What else gets me out of... Well, sometimes, like, an afternoon burrito will get me out of bed.
That'll do it.
Sometimes a nighttime burrito.
Big breakfast burritos. Sonic's got them, others don't. Grab a supersonic breakfast burrito loaded with eggs, sausage, cheese, jalapenos, and more. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
It started with a dream that led to a philosophy. That led to a mission. Never stop learning. Never stop winning.
Overcast Saturday in Lincoln, Nebraska. Yesterday, a 2-hour, 21-minute rain delay at the outset. And then the game lasted about that long. The forecast is for possible showers later on, but not until around 3 o'clock local. So weather people are optimistic that there will be nothing but baseball this afternoon at Hawks Field, Haymarket Park. 2-0 Nebraska as they send the 7, 8, 9 hitters up in the second inning. Half-mast flags today in honor of former governor and senator Jim Exon, who passed away yesterday at the age of 83. Moment of silence before our first pitch in honor of Jim Exon's passing. DH Ryan Bohannon to lead off the second. Cameron Deason the first, struck out Boyer looking, then gave Simakaitis base hit ahead of the two-run homer by Gordon, later a double by Andy Gertz. Fouled off the fist, 0-2. Freshman out of Goddard, Kansas, Ryan Bohannon. Valuable in a two-way role this year. They've used him on the mound. He's 1-1. And just to stay alive, he had a save in 20 appearances and a sparkling earned run average of .286. At the plate, .319. 11 runs batted in, and 10 of those in the last 3 weeks. He had a great Big 12 tournament, hit .400 in Oklahoma City, and also hit .400 here in the Lincoln Regional with 5 runs batted in, 2 in each of the Creighton games.
Taking advantage of an opportunity given to you. And at that time of the season, to be given a chance is pretty gutsy on Coach Anderson's part, but it's worked out.
Again, just stays alive at 0-2. Nebraska, one win away from their third trip to Rosenblatt Stadium, 50 miles away. A two-run homer by Alex Gordon off Brandon Camerdis in the first. Freshman All-America pitcher Johnny Dorn going in search of what would be his 12th victory against only one loss this year. Brandon Camerdis struck out two in the first, but in addition to the Alex Gordon home run, gave up a double to Daniel Bruce, to Andy Gertsch, and a single to Joe Simakaitis. Bo Hannon grounds out to begin the second. There was a real difference, Frank, in the expectations by the outfields yesterday.
Yeah, no question. This is yesterday, and you look and see where Nebraska's defense is playing right there. They're playing up against, their back's up against the wall, it seems like. And then you look at Miami, and they're playing like they're playing outside the infield. And then you put them together, and look at the difference in each of the outfields, especially center field and right field. It's just amazing, the concept, the thought, the ideas of each of the coaches. And I think what that tells you in a nutshell is that Miami has a little bit more team speed out in the outfield. They're not afraid to go back, run it down, whereas Nebraska feels more comfortable giving up the single and not going for the double or the triple, the extra base hit that could cause, you know, something to happen later on during the inning.
This park has such inviting power alleys. 2-1. Right center, 342. Left center, not much deeper, 356.
As big and strong as college kids are today with the aluminum bat, you're exactly right. A 2-0 ball game, for the most part, will not stay that way.
3-1 to the second baseman, Ryan Worley. Product of Papillion, Nebraska, just outside Omaha. 3-2. Worley recovering as Bohannon did before him from a slow start. 283 with 20 home runs on the year. 0-3 yesterday. Camerdis deep into counts. Went over the 20-pitch mark in the first inning. Really makes him work here. On deck hitter Jeff Christie not hitting like a number nine hitter at all in the postseason. First walk. Fourth base runner in 1 1/3 against Camerdis. Yesterday, Jeff Christie, 2-for-2, including a double, scored a run, stole a base. He didn't allow any. He was 2-for-2 in cutting down Hurricane Bay Steelers. One on a perfectly timed pitch out. Just could not have played a better game behind the plate or at the plate than Christie did.
No question. And that dictated a whole bunch. And Jabber Chamberlain, too, you know, being his catcher, had a lot to do with the confidence he had throwing his breaking ball as often as he did behind the count. I can't tell you how important it is to have a defensive catcher with the ability of a Jeff Christie to hold. You look at the team ERA of 2.62, you go, yeah, it's a great pitching staff, but you also have to credit the catcher for a lot of that. And that's what the pitchers all did. Credited Jeff Christie for doing a terrific job with them all year.
Southeast High School here in Lincoln, Barton County Community College. Christie replaced Adam Moore after a season-ending injury in February. Drafted out of high school by the Dodgers. He's controlled most of the running games, not just Miami. 43% is rated catching base stealers coming in to this Super Regional. 43% in the majors, you're right at or near the top.
No question, no question. And that is very, very impressive numbers.
Two and two. Top of the order, Jesse Boyer on deck. Ryan Worley first after a one-out walk. 2-0 lead already for the Huskers. Inning number two, game number two of this Super Regional, and Jeff Christie is strikeout victim number three.
Camaradie. Thank you.
You're right there on it.
I'm
on the
so
verge.
Close right there. Anyway, what was making him so effective right there is his changeup. That was a good changeup right there. And what was the best part about it was his arm speed was just the same as a fastball. You know, with the 10 to 12 miles an hour difference, fooled Christie right back to the dugout. Sorry, Brandon.
Well, I know what you're getting at. He's part of good camaraderie.
Thank you.
Everybody says that. Way up high and diving it head first, safe. Ryan Wehrle with the stolen base.
A lot of times with the lefty on the mound, base runners go on first move. And what Cameron Diaz has is a high leg kick. He went on first move, stole the base. Rodriguez yesterday and today, last two throws he's made down on stolen base attempts have not been very efficient, though.
Second inning in which Camberdis has to work at least 20 pitches. Number 20 of this inning, right back to him. And only the walk to Wehrle for Nebraska in the second, to the bottom of the second. 2-0. Huskers leading the Hurricanes.
Air freshener too strong? New metered release Aerometrics for a long-lasting fragrance that's never out of control.
This Father's Day, give Dad a razor he'll really love. The Motorola Razor. Now only $199.99. Only from Singular, raising the bar.
You think you're all that. She thinks you're all out of gas. That hurts. Wake up and smell the moisturizer, pal. Non-greasy Hydropower Moisturizer from L'Oreal. Hydrate skin for 24 hours. New Hydropower Moisturizer from L'Oreal Men's Expert.
The echo in the gym. The squeak of the shoes. The buzzer. The break. The whistle. The crowd. Swish. I left the game, but it'll never leave me.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
Lincoln, Nebraska, home of the Cornhuskers in the nation's heartland. And again, Haymarket Park, Hawks Field, jam-packed, standing room only. Better than 8,300 yesterday, and at least that many today, as they hope this is the day in which their Huskers will earn their third trip to the College World Series. Danny Valencia, Brandon Caton, Eddie Rodriguez for Miami in the second inning. First baseman Valencia pops it straight up. Going to come down right behind the mound, and the third baseman Alex Gordon takes charge for out number one.
Once again, couple of pitches, pop up. Let's go to the next hitter. Thing that impresses me about Jabba Yesse and Dorn early on today, and I mentioned it earlier, I'm going to mention it again, it's how important it is to throw the least amount of pitches necessary. Comedius has thrown 20-plus innings the first pitches, the first two innings, and he has drawn three pitches, two outs.
Just in fair territory, Gordon throws out Caton.
This is pretty right here. Alex Gordon gets himself under control, good pitch. Regroups on the move, nice throw to first base. Very natural, very natural, very nice.
You've been noticing how much he resembles the guy that the Royals hope he will resemble. resemble once they get him up to Kansas City, George Brett, and in the field, not too unlike George Brett.
Well, George had to make himself a good defensive third baseman. Watching Alex in infield, watching how many ground balls he takes before the game, you could see he's got the tools ahead of George in the defensive regard. I just sat there during BP today, though, and I just sat there and looked, and I said, boy, that is such a unbelievable swing comparison between him and Brett. Brett had a pretty good career. You know, if Kansas City hopes that he does anything like that, I think they'd be very happy when they sign him.
Alex followed the Royals growing up, although he didn't seem that overwhelmed by the fact they made him the number two overall pick. And he will have a chance to play for the team he followed as a young player. 2-2, this one just misses.
That's a good fastball right there. Mark Chapman has been very consistent in that pitch up in the zone so far this morning.
Line drive, left field, and off the glove of Jesse Boyer. A long run to get there, and he almost hauled it in on the warning track. Eddie Rodriguez is at second base with two outs.
Very nice effort right there by Jesse Boyer. At first, I thought it was a gapper all the way, but he hustled all the way, got a glove on it, but was just not able to take it in. Pitch up in the zone a little bit. Rodriguez extended his hands, got him out there, drove the ball left center field. Good effort by Boyer.
First base hit for Miami. Two-out double. Here's Roger Tomas, the DH, who was 1-for-3 yesterday with two strikeouts. And a big curve for strike one. Sophomore from Miramar, Florida. Last year, a freshman All-America, All-College World Series selection. To right field, and Andy Gertsch has him played perfectly. Hurricanes get their first hit, but they raced Eddie Rodriguez's two-out double, and through two, they still trail 2-0.
Hello? Remember me? I'm Digger the Dermatophyte, your nail infection. You may have tried to get me with these over-the-counter surface treatments, but I live deep under your nails. I made myself at home down here, and I'm not leaving. I may even spread out to other nails. I mean, would you look at this view?
If you have thick, discolored, or flaky nails, over-the-counter surface treatments might not reach the infection. That's why you should ask your doctor about prescription-only Lamisil tablets. Unlike surface treatments, Lamisil is a pill that works through the bloodstream to target and attack the infection at its source, under the nail. In fact, you may start to see clearer, healthier nails in just 3 months. Lamisil isn't for people with liver or kidney problems. In rare cases, serious side effects in the liver or serious skin reactions have occurred, so your doctor may do a simple blood test. Other side effects, including headache, diarrhea, indigestion, and rash, were generally mild. Ask your doctor about Lamisil. It could be your solution. Once daily Lamisil tablets. Get your nail infection where it grows.
The head coach of the Hurricanes, Jim Morris, joins us now as we move to the third inning. Coach, yesterday you threw your best out there. Cesar Carrillo was not quite as good as Jabba Chamberlain. How do you see the way this one has started today?
Well, it's just probably the same thing so far, to be honest. But Camardese has settled down. He's threw good last inning. And if he gets it going, you know, he can stop him.
Hey, Coach, what do you need to do? What are the hitters? Do you like the approach right now with Dorn being aggressive as such?
Well, we got to be. He throws strikes, he gets ahead of hitters just like yesterday, and we've got to be more aggressive, get a guy on base, and get a big hit.
Coach, we appreciate it, and good luck.
Thanks a lot.
Jim Morris has taken the Hurricanes to every Super Regional since they created it, seventh straight this year. The only times they have lost in the Super Regional round, they were, as they are here, away from Mark Light Field. In fact, they've lost their last 7 games away from Mark Light. Just about unbeatable at home. 0-for-2. All those losses, or both those losses, all in game 3. Right. So they at least pushed it by winning one game on the opponent home field. Joseph Mikitas leading off the third. Singled ahead of the Alex Gordon home run in the first.
Now, we haven't had a lot of an opportunity to talk about Simikaitis right here, but the coaching staff calls him the heart and soul of his ball club. All Big 12, first team, defensive shortstop, just a terrific ball player. His hitting's come along. Just has so much to offer, and everybody looks up to him as their team leader.
Starter all 4 years, senior from St. Louis. Drives this one way back to left. Jay is back, goodbye again. Just the third home run of the season for Joe Simikaitis. 3-0 Nebraska.
And that ball would have been out of any ballpark down the left field line. That ball was smoked. Once again, trying to get inside. Left it right out over the plate. Every pitch, every ball that's been hit hard off of Cameron Diaz today has been missed in the strike zone, which is a kiss of death.
Alex Gordon now, who hit his 19th of the season in the first to get the Huskers off 2-0. Three home runs now in 11-plus innings off Miami pitching. 0-2 to Gordon. And facing elimination, this is one of those games where Jim Morris cannot allow a starter to search for his stuff and watch the lead grow. Three may be about as much as they can afford to get behind Johnny Dorr.
And I'll be perfectly honest with you, Dave. I would have thought that he'd have somebody warming up in the bullpen by now, just in case. You're right. You got to leave everything out in the field right now. This is your season.
Jim Morris didn't have to go to the bullpen at all yesterday behind Carrillo. Complete game, 6 hits, 7 strikeout loss. Just blown away, and Gordon works the count full. So everybody rested, everybody available. Morris hoping his offense can ignite and that Cameron Diaz can settle down, but that's not a good sign, working a walk to Gordon following the home run by Simikaitis.
And on top of that, walking him after an 0-2 count. Cameron Diaz is just at the point right now. And JT Arteaga comes out to the mound to talk to him. And while doing this, what you need to do, what JT has got to do right now is tell Cameron Diaz, regroup, leave everything out in the field right now. When he's missing, he's missing. When he, in that at-bat with Gordon, he threw a couple of quality sliders after being ahead 0-2 that just missed. As a former pitcher, I'm okay with that. The thing that hurts, and it has hurt him in the first couple of innings here, is the two balls he's given up for home runs. We talk about being wild and being wild in the zone. He has been wild in the zone when he got himself in trouble, and in this ballpark with the wind blowing out the left field, it has hurt him a couple of times.
Well, the bullpen will get into action now with sophomore Ricky Orta heading down to get loose. And Curtis Ledbetter, cleanup hitter digging in, popped up first time. Nobody out, a run in, Gordon at first. And strike one from Cameron Diaz.
Now Gordon's a threat to steal. This year, 23 out of 26 in stolen bases. He said that's the one thing he worked on more than anything during the offseason. It's paid off. Cameron Diaz has a high leg kick. See if he could read him and go. And Rodriguez has had a little trouble throwing down the second base, so.
Curtis Ledbetter, the MVP of the Big 12 tournament. Over three games in Oklahoma City, had a stretch of 7 consecutive hits. A 5-hit, 4-run game against Missouri. This one is popped into shallow center. Figueroa started out, moves in. 1 out in the third. And Ledbetter, 0-2. ESPN2's coverage of the road to Omaha Underway tonight, beginning at 7 Eastern, game two of the Florida-Florida State matchup, plus other regional coverage. Gators won the opener yesterday at 10 Eastern, game one out west, USC and Oregon State. All Pac-10 and that super regional in Corvallis. The road to Omaha tonight, 7 and 10 Eastern on ESPN2. Gertz, a two-out double in the first. Freshman from Lincoln, transfer from Arkansas, where he was on scholarship. He left that situation with the Razorbacks to walk on for the Huskers, play for the hometown program. Gertz came in one of their hottest hitters. Very valuable defensively, too. They can put him anywhere. And he puts that one right through the hole. He's two for two. Gordon down to second with still only one out. And now Daniel Bruce.
I really like the approach that the Nebraska hitters are taking against Cameron, especially the second time through the lineup. He's thrown so many pitches, and he's mixed and matched. They have everything he's got. Now it's just a question of when he throws his off-speed pitch, even if your body's flying open a little bit, make sure you keep your hands back like Gertz did right there and just put the ball in play. Good things happen when you put the ball in play.
And down in the bullpen, Orta pretty much ready. And I would think Camardese may well be pitching to his last hitter if he loses Bruce. He just cannot afford to fall much further behind than they already are, with their offense providing nothing so far against Nebraska pitching.
As I said, elimination game, you leave everything out in the field. Ricky Orta was scheduled to be the third game starter, but right now Coach Morris is not worried about game three. He's trying to win game two.
Bruce, the senior from Omaha, looks at ball two, 2-1. Good offensive contributor. Great in the outfield. He has twice been voted the best outfield arm in the Big 12 by the conference's coaches. Back to the screen, 2-2.
Just add to that a little bit. Coach Anderson said not only is he that, but when you talk about his arm, he doesn't show it off as much. He says he's got what he takes, but he says what impresses him about his arm is he's as accurate as well as a strong arm when needed.
Nebraska male student athlete of the year. Three balls and two strikes. Already one walk issued by Camardese here in the third.
If you're Coach Anderson, knowing what he told us the first day here about they love playing aggressive baseball with a 3-0 lead, I'm sending the runners right here. Let's see if Coach Anderson does. He preached aggressive baseball.
Remember, Gordon already 23 for 26 stealing this year. And he is going, but it's ball four to load the bases.
Now you got a lefty coming up to the plate in Bohan, and you got Camardese struggling, but you got the lefty. Ord is ready in the bullpen, but he's a right-hander. I give him one opportunity right here to get the lefty out. And that might be the ball game for Camardese.
They said stamina was a big issue ever since he came down with the mumps last month. This one is ripped up the middle, base hit. Gordon comes home, followed by Gertz, and they will hold the runner Bruce at third base. A two-run double by Ryan Bohannon, 5-0 Nebraska. 50 miles down I-80. Looks closer every minute. Jim Morris gets 2 1/3 out of Cambridge. He leaves having surrendered the 5 runs on 6 hits, 4 of them for extra bases. And Ricky Orta, the sophomore right-hander from Miami, will come on and try to prevent any further damage.
Soccer goalposts, $96. Supersonic jet, $20. Fire truck, $32. Watching the imaginations grow. Priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Accepted at your favorite home and garden store.
Because your offense can't get off the field. Johnny Dorn staked to a 5-0 lead.
Gotta love that, no question. The thing that was impressive to me was that Nebraska went after Cameron Deese. They worked him, they worked him. They knew that his stamina issue was a question mark. And in 2 1/3 innings, I believe he threw 60-plus pitches.
63.
63 to be exact, and exactly what the book says. He tired him out, he got pitches up in the zone, and they made him pay for it. Excellent approach by all Nebraska hitters today.
Orta, the first reliever used by Miami here. This is going to be an interesting kid to watch because J.D. Arteaga, his pitching coach, says he's been a challenge to work with because he wants to trick everybody. He wants to throw 17 different pitches from 17 different arm angles, a la El Duque. And he will shake off his pitching coach. He's not shy about that. Lots of movement, sometimes more movement than he could handle and still keep it in the strike zone.
But he's got tremendous, tremendous stuff. Infield in with one out. They cannot let, Miami cannot let any more runs score.
And the first pitch attempted squeeze bunt by Ryan Wehrle. Trying to bring Daniel Bruce home from third. Bohanna down at second with 3 runs already in on 3 hits, 2 walks.
They're leaving it out there. Coach Anderson, very aggressive baseball. Good job of Wehrle getting a bat on the ball. The pitch was up out of the zone, but that's a job of squeeze. Put the bat on the ball somehow.
Outfield in two, the 0-1 pitch, 0-2.
That was a good slider right there by Orta.
He can get it up to 90 on occasion. And if he can keep things in the zone, handle his own movement, he can be just about unhittable. In tight. Problem with so many arm angles is it's tough to repeat your pitches.
Right.
When pitchers try to just get in a slot and find the same release point, isn't that hard enough to do with only one? Slow roller, third baseman Braun, who now has at second base, Bohannon in a rundown. Bruce trying to come home, rundown, and tagged out at third base by Braun. So they end the inning with a double play, but the Huskers with another home run, 3 more runs through 2.5 in total command of game 2 of the Super Regional.
The U.S. Open, America's championship in the most demanding test in golf. Masters champion Tiger Woods takes aim at his second major of the year, while Phil Mickelson, Vijay Singh, and Umyaz battle the sandhills of legendary Pinehurst. The game's greatest players push to the limit in pursuit of one of golf's most prestigious prizes, the 150th U.S. Open. Live coverage begins Thursday at 10 a.m. Eastern on ESPN.
Guts and grit. The NBA's best put on an amazing display in Game 1 of the Finals. The Pistons and Spurs slugged it out. Every shot contested. Every player pushed to the limit. Fourth quarter heroics from Duncan and Ginobili gave San Antonio the victory. The defending champs are determined to even things out. The NBA Finals, where legends are born. Pistons, Spurs, Game 2, Sunday 8:30 Eastern on ABC.
Back in Lincoln, where we're joined by the Huskers head coach, Mike Anderson, and so many things have gone right for you today, 5-0. Seems kind of odd, but we'll ask you about maybe the one thing that's gone wrong. What went wrong in that inning-ending double play?
Well, we just didn't read the runner in front of us. Ryan Bohannon, good base hit, but ball's got to get through the infield in that situation. Then he's got to also read the runner in front of him, and unfortunately didn't on that one.
Hey, I just want to talk about Joseph Mikitis a little bit, Coach. You hear all about Alex Gordon and this and Alex Gordon and that, which is all warranted. But, I mean, what is the importance of Joseph Mikitis on your ball club?
Joe's our leader. He's fearless. He's passionate about this game. He plays the game hard. And, you know, that just transcends the other players on our team. He's a great competitor for us.
Coach, good luck. Best of the way. We appreciate it.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Mike Anderson, third-year head coach. Two Big 12 titles. Big 12 Coach of the Year this year. An assistant 8 years. And the Huskers led the Big 12 in hitting each of his last 4 years in that capacity before he replaced Dave Van Horn, who took over down in Arkansas. Number 9 hitter, Walter Diaz, in the third inning. And then the Figueroas will hit against Johnny Dorn, who's allowed only one base hit, a two-out double in the second by Eddie Rodriguez.
Very important right here. This is an important inning for Johnny Dorn to establish, get ahead, get these guys off the field. They're feeling good about themselves. He's got 5 runs on the board, first 3 innings. Dorn's got to get them off the field right here.
Right in there, 2-2. Freshman from Miami, Diaz, drafted as a shortstop out of high school. When Roger Tomas came down with Crohn's disease, he became limited to the DH, and Diaz steps in. Was named All Coral Gables Regional Shortstop last week. Another product of Christopher Columbus High School, as was John Jay, among others. Dorn's 2-2, call strike on the outside corner. First strikeout today for the freshman All-America, Johnny Dorn.
Great spot right there for the fastball. Got behind 2-0, but he came right back and did what he's supposed to do. Challenged the number 9 here to get him out of there. Now concentrate at the top of the order and Danny Figueroa.
Who shows bunt, takes strike 1. We said both the Figueroas drafted by the Orioles. 42nd round for Danny. 9th round for Paco. On the left side for Simakaitis at short. The off-balance throws, perfect.
Got some sweet hands right there. That was a tough hop he just made look easy. Important, such an importance of getting the top of the order out. Good pitch right there. Ground ball is short. Simakaitis, just great set of hands. Gets his feet under him and nice throw to first base. I mean, that was not an easy play. Ball did not come up. It stayed down. He stayed low on it. Made the play look easy.
Danny now 0-for-6 here in Lincoln. And now Paco, who's had a completely different time. A fourth inning home run for the only Miami run yesterday. 3-for-4, and he flied to center. 3-for-5 now after his first at bat. Francisco Paco Figueroa. Coaches were pretty unanimous before Danny's injuries, which led to Tommy John surgery, and then it is rehab from that shoulder surgery resulted. Before that, Danny, they felt, was possibly the best center fielder ever to come through the Hurricane program. And since then, Paco has pretty much passed up his twin brother. Paco, in fact, played some center field when Danny was out. And within a couple of weeks, he was almost as good as Danny in that new spot. Four straight, six out of the last seven retired. Couple of ground balls all Miami can manage here in the third. 5-0.
Since 1989, Coca-Cola has provided more than $35 million in college scholarships. And as the NCAA's first corporate champion, Coca-Cola proudly supports 88 NCAA championships in 23 sports for 360,000 student athletes every year. Satisfying a thirst for learning, both in the classroom and on the field. The Coca-Cola Company and the NCAA.
Pillaging. But with so many people switching to Capital One, we've had to find new jobs.
Maybe a 7.5. No!
It's been especially tough on Ivan the Great.
For low rates and great rewards, switch to Capital One. Check your mailbox.
What's in your wallet? What are you looking at?
Six innings away from heading east on I-80. The Nebraska Cornhuskers, 3-1 winners yesterday, 5-0. They lead today heading into the fourth. Hawks Field, Haymarket Park, sold out in 13 hours. 8,300 plus yesterday, at least that many here today. Just a gem. This facility opened in 2002. They share it with the minor league team here, the Lincoln Salt Dogs. And it is the equal of just about any college facility, and for that matter, most minor league facilities you'll find anywhere.
Yeah, it is very impressive. Very impressive. First class, just the Nebraska people as a whole has treated us real well. Miami as well. It's been a pleasure being here. It's a two quality college programs here we're seeing.
Miami, which has been so dominant for so long, and Nebraska trying to get to that level. And with Mike Anderson following the groundwork of Dave Van Horn, who got them to their first two College World Series, just a seamless transition. Big 12 regular season and postseason champions. Win that tournament in Oklahoma City. They lost the opener to Texas Tech, and then from that point on, they have not lost again. They won their next five in the Oklahoma City. It culminated with a 1-0 win in the championship game against Baylor. They swept their two here in the regional against Illinois, Chicago, and Creighton. Two opponents, three wins, two of them against the Blue Jays as Jeff Christie grounds out to begin the fourth. And going for a two-game sweep of the Hurricanes. Our coverage of the road to Omaha continues tomorrow afternoon with a doubleheader. Beginning at 1 Eastern, top-ranked Tulane against Rice in Game 2. Baylor and Clemson to follow at 4 Eastern with their second game from Waco. As the road to Omaha on ESPN continues tomorrow afternoon. Right in the back of Jesse Boyer. Ricky Orta allows his first base runner with one out here in the fourth.
He's thrown a number of pitches inside since he's come into the game. That's just a fastball that got away from mid-back. That'll feel good later. But each of the three hitters he's faced so far, he's come in way inside on each of them at least one pitch. But they've made a good point earlier. The problem you have with a pitcher like Ricky Horton is, as good a stuff as he has, the inconsistency of his arm slot does not give him the possibility of really locating the ball as well as other kids who have that consistent arm slot.
Strike one to Simbakaitis, a hero already today, singled ahead of the Alex Gordon first inning home run. He led off the third with a solo shot. His third of the year, first ever in the postseason for the senior. Simbakaitis out of St. Mary's High School in St. Louis, which has produced some baseball talent way before he got there. Yogi Berra and Joe Garagiola, who went through the same time. Simbakaitis, the toughest out so far for Carrillo and Camardese, the two Hurricane starters. Huerta gets his first crack at him here. Boyer down at first after getting hit. He got hit by Oklahoma in Oklahoma City. Carrillo so outstanding yesterday in his complete game. Hard luck loss. Boyer, after he was hit by that pitch against the Sooners, did not return. Sat out the last four games in Oklahoma City. But appears to be handling his latest with no problem. A bluff down at first. Two balls and two strikes to Simbakaitis.
Jesse Boyer has good speed over first base, but as the coaching staff mentioned, he's not the best of base runners. Tells me that he has a little trouble picking up.
Double play ball. But the throw gets away from Valencia. And Simbakaitis on base again. Boyer erased at second. Alex Gordon quiet yesterday, 0 for 3. Gave early notice today he would not suffer through back-to-back offers. Following Simbakaitis' first inning single with a long 19th home run of the year. Last time up, walked following Simbakaitis' solo shot. And Orta starts off speed and low.
That's what All-Americans do. All-Americans jumpstart your ball club. And yesterday going 0 for 3, Chamberlain and Christie picked him up. But today, Alex Gordon decided, you know what, let's go, boys. Let's go for a ride. And took him first inning home run.
People here who have watched both the players, Alex Gordon and the player he may have surpassed in some minds as the best ever in the program, Darren Erstad, who was the first overall pick in the draft 10 years ago. And the similarities go beyond just where they were drafted. Gordon, one pick after Erstad, second overall by Kansas City. Career average, .356. Exactly Erstad's career average. 43 homers coming into this regional. 185 at-bats in Gordon's career. 41 home runs and 3 fewer runs batted in. In 68 more at-bats in Darren Erstad's career in Lincoln. Simbakaitis was off with the pitch. It is the second straight walk issued to Gordon and his third in the two games here in the Super Regional.
Pretty comparable.
Almost impossible to have numbers that near identical and then be picked in almost the identical spot. Erstad, who also contributed to the Nebraska football team across the highway, is a great punter. Gordon has stuck to baseball, done pretty well.
And Darren Erstad has done a tremendous job for the Anaheim Angels over the years. When he is healthy, when he stays healthy, boy, he makes things happen over there.
Alex's father, Mike, played baseball here. Brother Eric, playing at Nebraska Omaha. Curtis Ledbetter has popped out and flied out, 0 for 2. Ball and a strike to the cleanup hitting first baseman. First team, all Big 12 selection. Hit sharply to short, and it goes through Diaz. Coming home, Gordon, the throw is in time. Rodriguez blocks the plate, and Gordon is out number 3. Ledbetter reaching on the air by Diaz. But the throw to recover from the air in plenty of time. And Simakaitis cut down on the tag by Rodriguez. Still 5-0.
At Lexus, we developed an air purification system that uses ultraviolet technology and micron filters to help eliminate any odors and airborne irritants from the cabin, even pollen. Because we don't want anything, no matter how small, to spoil your drive.
What's hot?
Hooters hot!
That's right, Hooters is hot for great food, fun, and cold beer. There's no place hotter than Hooters. Try the hot and light menu today. And win a trip to Miami for the Hooters International Swimsuit Pageant with me. Or watch it live with the Hooters girls. Now that's hot. For hot summer fun, this is Brooke Burke saying Hooters is what's hot.
Hooters Magazine, available at newsstands today.
Chris, is there any more Coke?
This is a tough one.
Put in gear, let's go.
So is mastering the complexities of automatic transmission. Realizing when to use the putter.
And find the right look for graduation.
But maybe not as tough for me as for my dad.
Yeah, I got one right here.
But man, he's getting his own ice.
Ryan Braun to lead off the Hurricane fourth. They have got to get something going, or this is going to be a quick two and out for them. They've managed only one hit so far against Dorn. Gordon, meanwhile, one of the home runs. Two-run shot off Cameron Dees, who was only in for 2 1/3. The Miami offense hitting 189 in their first 12 innings here in Lincoln. That's our Diet Coke game track. The NCAAs and Coca-Cola, nothing like it. Dorn has allowed only 2 base runners. The first was Braun on a 2-out walk. He stole second in the first. That's where it ended. The only hit was a 2-out double by Eddie Rodriguez in the second. And this one lofted to left field. Boyer started back, now comes in. Out number 1, Braun 0-for-5 in the Super Regional. And an update now from the studio and Dave Revson.
Dave Rice, the early lead on number 1 national seed Tulane. Josh Rodriguez here scoring Tyler Henley. The 2003 national champs getting to Houston's first-round pick. Brian Bogusevic in a big way in the first. It's 4-0 in favor of the Owls.
First pitch to John Jay is driven in the air to left field. Way back and gone. First home run of the year for the Miami cleanup hitter. First run of the day, John Jay will be greeted by the entire Hurricane team, relieved that they can finally get something going against Johnny Dorn.
Taking the approach that they have all day today is being aggressive. First pitch, knowing Dorn's going to be around the plate. Breaking ball out over the plate. Windstream going to left center field. That ball just took off. It looked like a pop-up off the bat, but it went out and cleared pretty well. Good job of hitting right there. Dorn's got to get back and know it's a 5-1 ball game. That was it. Solo homer, nobody hurt. Go back out and get this pattern.
Cleanup hitter. followed Ryan Braun, who has 18 home runs. So Jim Morris obviously looking for something a little different from his cleanup hitter than most do in the classic sense of that role. Valencia with a bounce to Simakaitis for the second out. He's 0 for 2. So John Jay, in the absence of any other offense today, steps up, does something he hasn't done all year. And both Miami runs have been on solo shots. Yesterday, leading off the fourth inning, Paco Figueroa. All they managed against Jamba Chamberlain. Johnny Dorn just about as effective in his first 3 2/3. Brendan Caton now, right fielder. First time up, grounded to third. High hopper here for the shortstop, and again, Simakaitis is right on it. But the Hurricanes finally get to Johnny Dorn. John Jay finally gets into the home run column this year. It's 5-1 headed to the fifth.
I'm tempted to for a moment, and she feels better than ever, and we're on fire, making our way back from Mars. I'm 33 for a moment.
The road of life takes many turns. There are over 900 Chase credit cards to help you make the most of every one. Your choice, your Chase.
Introducing a conventional oil that totally defies convention. New Mobil Clean 5000, the first oil enhanced with a high endurance formula, the only one guaranteed to protect for 5,000 miles. Mobil Clean 5000, the oil that's changing oil.
Brandon Cambardese lasted just 2 1/3. He's not allowed a hit yet, but he hit Jesse Boyer, walked Alex Gordon in the fourth. Curtis Ledbetter then with an error by the shortstop Diaz, who threw out Simakaitis trying to score from second base. It's Gertsch, Bruce, and Bohannon here in the Husker fifth. Nebraska, the visiting team, they were home yesterday. Two balls, no strikes from Orta. With a hesitation in his delivery, now pours one in, 2-1.
Just a slight herky-jerky there.
Working quickly, breaking ball, a little bit outside. Pre-pharmacy major and an honor student. Ricky Orta, sophomore. And a leadoff walk for Gertsch. Not a good start to the fifth inning for Orta. For a preview of the NCAA Men's College World Series, log on to NCAAsports.com, the official online home for all 88 NCAA championships. Program has produced so many national titles, beginning with 1983, the baseball team with four, Nebraska, hoping that this is the year they will break through. Not just reach Rosenblatt Stadium, but win there. Short bunt, and plenty of time for Rodriguez, who didn't have to come far out of his crouch to throw out Andy Gertz down at second.
Eddie Rodriguez comes out of the, really gets out of the box quick behind the plate. Good pick at shortstop by Walter Diaz. Good heads-up baseball right there. Eddie Rodriguez, the last couple of innings, play at the plate to end the inning last inning, blocking the plate as he did, and getting up out of the crouch right there and getting that ball and getting it down to second base. Nice job. He's recovering well from his throwing difficulties earlier today and a little bit yesterday, but part of the game.
Now freshman Ryan Bohannon is at bat in the third, about as big as any. A two-run double to score Gordon and Gertz after Simakaitis had started the inning with a homer. Three-run game became a 5-0 game. Miami's four national titles won under both their great coaches, Ron Fraser, in 82 and 85. Jim Morris, 99, and again in 2001. This Nebraska team on such a roll, they've won their last 9 games coming into today. Jim Morris knows all about that. That last champion of his, 2001, won their last 17 games that year. And in the final, 12-1, they polished off Stanford. High breaking ball.
The thing that people don't realize either, Dave, is you're not talking about a big university in Miami. You're talking about 8,500 people, 8,500 students. What they accomplished in their sports endeavors is just amazing. He was mentioning, Coach Frazier, that the average student is a 4.0 student.
Going Daniel Bruce on the pitch out. The throw gets through into center. Here comes the throw to third. Not in time. Daniel Bruce from first to third on the second Miami error of the day on the throw by the catcher Rodriguez.
Once again, pitch out Rodriguez all the time in the world. His short arms a little bit. His throws have been on the shortstop side and short pretty much his whole series. He's really struggling with his throwing arm. But let me just finish it. We had average student at Miami, 4.0 with a 1280 SAT. That's impressive. That's telling me that not only do you have a great athlete, but you also have a great student going there as well.
Yeah, if you're just a lousy 3.9 student, you're bringing down the curve.
That's what Coach Morris said as well. A Miami student stays at home as well.
Nebraska has produced their share of academic All-Americas through the year as well. Fouled off. Last 10 years where Mike Anderson has been either the assistant or the head coach, 46 academic All-Conference, 8 academic All-Americas. So both these programs stress that year after year. Athletic Director Steve Peterson, fairly new on the job. Swung on and missed. Ryan Bohannon is out number two here in the fifth. Orta's first strikeout. And Ryan Wehrle will try and keep it going.
Looking for a pitch inside. Perfect pitch right there by Ricky Orta. Nice job. Infield was in. Now you got two outs. Now you got to bear down and get this guy out. Keep your ball club in the ball game.
Strike one to Ryan Wehrle. These teams have had the memorable meetings on the football field. That 1983 team, Nebraska, was supposed to be the greatest in college football history, and they might have been if Miami hadn't surprised them in the Orange Bowl. But Tom Osborne would recover and win couple of national titles of his own, and Steve Peterson now overseeing an expansion of Memorial Stadium north end zone. With suites added, seats added, they're going to get that capacity up well over 80,000 by the time that project is finished for the 2006 football season. And what they've done with the baseball program here speaks for itself.
Yeah, just talking to Steve before the game, you know, we talk about the male sports, but then you also have, we just mentioned about volleyball. He says he has a standing room only crowd for volleyball. I mean, the sports here in Nebraska and the crowds here are unbelievable. You talk about supporting a program. Just take a look around here. All you see is red. All you see is, and the thing that amazes me is how classy these fans are. They don't even boo the opponent. You're in another, you're New York or Boston, you're booed off the field. Yeah, they're no booing at all. It's just very respectful fans who just love their athletes.
Well, football fans are noted for cheering the opponent, that the rare opponent that comes in and beats Nebraska at Memorial Stadium.
And that doesn't happen too often, does it?
2-2 pitch. Softly for Paco Figueroa, and just ahead of the diving Worley at first. Little cue shot. Worley almost beat it out. Orta works through more trouble to keep it 5-1.
Our plan this summer is to have fun inside and out.
Get your summer off on the right foot. At the Home Depot, you can. With 10% off all carpet and vinyl purchases of $2.99 or more when installed through the Home Depot. That's 10% off installation, too. Plus, right now, get no payments, no interest for 12 months on purchases throughout the store with your Home Depot or Expo Consumer credit card.
The Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Now you can learn the fundamentals of baseball from Major Leaguers, Hall of Fame players, and All-Star legends. Introducing Harold Reynolds Presents Baseball in association with ESPN.
You got a chance to learn from the best. Tony Gwynn on hitting.
Left field, center field, right field.
13 gold gloves. I'm talking about Ozzie Smith. Good pitching does stop good hitting. Let's hear what Jeff Brantley has to say about pitching.
And you're going to try to drive down and through the baseball.
15 years in the major leagues. Joe Girardi, he's teaching catching. Torrey Hunter, he's going to teach you about outfield play.
Here, hop, throw.
Let's listen to what Buck Showalter has to say about practice.
You want to make sure that he stays right on this bag and doesn't take a turn.
Coaching is so important.
For a limited time, get the first DVD in the series, Hitting with Tony Gwynn, for the unbelievable price of only $29.95. But there's more. Only through this offer, you'll get each additional DVD at our special introductory price of only $19.95. Don't miss this opportunity to own one of the most comprehensive baseball training tools ever created.
Dave Repson, our Sports Air in-game studios. Rice in Tulane. Micah Owings into right field. Lance Pendleton overruns it a bit, but makes up for it. Joe Savory the relay. Nathan Southard gunned down at the plate. It's now 4-0. We told you it was 4-0 before, but in the middle of our last update, guys, Rice had a run taken off for leaving early on a sack fly. They just got that run back, so it's 4-0. Rice over the Green Wave.
Green Wave, top national seed. Trying to beat the defending champ, Rice Owls, from a couple of years ago. Knocked off by Cal State Fullerton last year, atop the college baseball world. Eddie Rodriguez, Roger Tomas, Walter Diaz in the fifth for the Hurricanes. Rodriguez has doubled for one of only two hits allowed by Johnny Dorn. Otherwise, he struggled. Nebraska base stealers were 2-for-2 against him yesterday. They're 2-for-2 today, and he also has a throwing error. Only three base runners allowed today by Johnny Dorn. Ryan Braun, a two-out walk in the first. Rodriguez with his double with two outs in the second. And the run scored on John Jay's solo home run with one out in the fourth. And Rodriguez now 2-for-2. He gets the fifth inning started. Dorn facing the bottom third of the Hurricane order. Mom Vicky watching on. Her son, the freshman All-America from Grand Island, Nebraska, going for his 12th victory in 13 decisions this year. And the last 2 months, since April 15th, 7 of his 11 wins, 7-0 with a 147 earned run average.
It's getting stronger as you go along. It's nice to see. You know, freshmen today grow up so quick in these programs. You know, by the end of the season, you're not a freshman anymore.
A bluff off first. And too bad for Miami that Rodriguez didn't continue on. Might have prevented a double play. First turn by Nebraska here in the fifth inning.
Taylor made right there. Just a beautiful. It's so much fun watching this Nebraska team. Fundamentally, they're as sound as any team I've seen. Order just throwing strikes, keeping them on their toes, making plays behind. It's really fun baseball.
Strike one to Walter Diaz, who struck out looking first time.
And that was one of the higher strike calls by Mark Chapman, who's been very consistent behind the plate today.
It's going against you the way it is, Jim Morris. You'll bluff a runner, but not send him off first. Result, instead of man at second, one out. Base is empty, two outs, and now 0-2 to your number nine hitter. It has been that way for Nebraska both days here in this Lincoln Super Regional. Just off the plate, a ball and two strikes. In the regional against Creighton, Doran had to wait out two rain delays. He went 6 2/3 to continue this streak. Grounder toward the hole, backhand, Simakaitis. The throw bounces in time. Joe Simakaitis continues sparkling play defensively. He's had a hot bat offensively. He's helped the Huskers lead 5-1.
At Honda, we see more than just a racing engine. We see competition leading to innovation. Our engineers learning, our products improving, and our drivers winning. Even when the track is miles away.
So, what have you been up to?
Nothing.
So what have you guys been up to?
Nothing.
Yeah, I have a little attitude, but I've earned it. I've put in the hours. I practice every day. I've learned from the best, and I have no doubt that I can play at the highest level. Right now, I'm guessing I'll end up in either Chicago or New Orleans.
Most good jazz musicians do.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
One headed to the sixth. The NBA Finals headed to game two on ABC. Tomorrow night, the defending champions down 1-0 to Tim Duncan and the San Antonio Spurs. Game two, ABC Sports Sunday, 8:30 Eastern from San Antonio, where the Spurs broke open a tight game late in game one to win going away, 83-69.
You're going to see that score, that type of score, the rest of the series, both defensive-minded teams.
Jeff Christie leading off the sixth. 0-2 today after his 2-for-2 game one, which included a double, a run scored, and a stolen base. 5-1, Nebraska actually can look at a lot of missed opportunities today. They've had somebody in scoring position in every inning. They've left at least one on every inning. Right to Walter Diaz to retire Christie. With men in scoring position, they're only 1-for-7. They've left a total of 6 on. And also, they can look back at a couple of base running errors. And thrown out at home and thrown out at the plate. Christie is the only Cornhusker not to have reached against Camberdees or Orta. back now. Top of the order, Jesse Boyer. He reached as a hit batsman last time. 0 for 2. The Husker left fielder. Sure, it doesn't seem to the Hurricanes as if Nebraska's missed a lot of chances. 2 in the first on the Gordon homer. 3 in the third on the Simakaitis solo shot. And the Ryan Bohannon two-run double.
Borda has done exactly what Coach Morris wanted him to do, is keep the team in the ballgame, give him a chance to score, give him a chance to win this ballgame. And that's exactly what he's done so far. No runs in his 3 2/3 innings.
Second base, backhanded by Paco Figueroa. Not a routine chance. Paco handled it about as well as you can, and Boyer now 0 for 3. Now Simakaitis, who in the third inning delivered our sonic blast of the day. Leading off against Brandon Camerdis. Turned a 2-0 game into a 3-0 game, and then the Huskers would follow with two more, chasing the Miami starter. Ricky Orta has not allowed a hit yet. But Nebraska pitching has allowed yesterday and today combined 2 runs on 10 hits in 14 innings.
With only 1 walk, which is very impressive.
That is the most amazing thing. Chamberlain and Jensen did not walk a batter yesterday. Ryan Braun with 2 outs walking off Dorn in the first. And that's the only one he's allowed. They've been so much more efficient. Dorn throwing only 7 pitches to get through the fourth. And through 4 innings, Miami pitching had thrown exactly twice as many pitches as Dorn. Two of two to Simakaitis. Three yesterday so far, also 2 for 3 today. This is a pop up into shallow right, and the right fielder Brendan Caton makes it the first 1-2-3 inning for Hurricane pitchers today. Middle of the sixth, still 5-1.
When we got married, suddenly we had 2 of everything.
They had a lot of stuff.
2 dining sets, 2 dogs.
2 car insurance companies.
I'm State Farm agent Joan Reisum, and this is a true story.
We had to get rid of a few things.
Yeah, mainly my things.
He had State Farm.
She had a Gecko.
I helped them compare rates and coverage.
It was no comparison.
He was right, for once.
This time, one of my things stayed.
Last year, 1.3 million drivers switched to State Farm. Call an agent today and you'll switch too.
Like a good neighbor,
State Farm is there.
This year, he'll spend 32 hours trimming bushes, 61 hours mowing the lawn, 52 hours watering flowers. But he won't have to refinish his deck for another 4 years. Behr Premium Weatherproofing Wood Sealer and Finish with Silicone. 4-year protection against rain, sun, wind, and snow, guaranteed. Behr. Good. Better. Behr.
Is your dandruff on full blast? Turning people off? Garnier Fructis Fortifying Anti-Dandruff Shampoo. Created with Parithione Zinc, it blows dandruff flakes away. It's proven. The Garnier Fructis system makes hair up to 5 times stronger. So much shinier. So effective, no flakes, guaranteed. Kiss those flakes goodbye. For hair that shines with all its strength, Garnier Fructis Fortifying Anti-Dandruff Shampoo.
Garnier.
Those two guys have nailed it. Dorn absolutely has been a star on ESPN today. 5-1, working on a 3-hitter into the 6th inning. Top of the order for the Hurricanes, Danny and Paco Figueroa, and then Ryan Braun. 56 pitches, 7 in the fourth, one of which produced the only Hurricane run, the home run by John Jay. Just 10 pitches to get through the fifth. Helped out by the double play. And now Danny Figueroa still looking to get his first super regional hit. 0 for 4 with 3 strikeouts yesterday, 2 groundouts today, and behind 0-2.
And I can't tell you how important it is to keep that leadoff hitter on Miami off the bases with the speed that they possess. Danny Figueroa made things happen all year. Guy going 0 for 6 thus far. Not much Miami offense can do.
In the regional, Danny Figueroa was the toughest out. 8 for 12, including a homer. He was on base 10 of his 14 plate appearances. Little bit high, 2-2. 6 for 6 in stealing, including 3 stolen bases in the first game of the regional. Scored 6 runs. And as he went, the Hurricane offense went. But that was the regional. The number 2 pitching staff in the country has completely smothered one of the top hitting attacks in the country. And coming in, you would think that it might be just the opposite. The Nebraska attack had scored about a quarter fewer runs per game than the Hurricanes. Here's a leadoff walk, and Figueroa reaches for the first time. Just the second walk issued by Dorn. Second walk, in fact, by all Nebraska pitching.
The problem you have, though, is that good pitching will always beat good hitting at any level. That's what it comes down to. And look at the stat right there for Miami on the road. That's saying we got to get something happening, boys.
May 14th, their last victory away from Mark Light Field in Miami. And that was a 1-0 nail-biter. 7-game road losing streak. Two games in the ACC tournament were also losses. They totaled only 2 runs against North Carolina State and Clemson. May 14th, they beat Virginia 1-0 in Charlottesville, and that is the last time the Hurricanes have triumphed on an opponent's home field. Paco Figueroa 0 for 2 today, 3 for 4 yesterday, including a home run. This is what Jim Morris got an inkling of when they had the surprising 6-game losing streak entering the regional. Toward right center, and Andy Gertz has the first out. Through the ACC tournament, a 6-game losing streak, all those away from Miami. And he said not only were they losing, they were practicing poorly too, and it carried over.
But while we were talking, Danny Figueroa, heads up base runner, went from first to second. No timeout called.
This on the fly ball, routine play, or so it appeared for Andy Gertz and Wright. And Danny starts by going halfway. But then as the conference takes place between Simakaitis and Dorn, Danny alertly looks up and sees nobody's covering second.
That's an impressive base running right there. There was no timeout called.
Mike Anderson now wanting an explanation from the second base umpire, Chuck Lyon.
Figueroa goes back to first base.
Right now, he's not thinking about anything spectacular until he looks up, and then how alert is that?
That's fantastic baseball. That really is.
First pitch, Ryan Braun. Strike one. A walk and a flyout today. 0 for 5 in the Super Regional for the ACC Player of the Year. And along with Alex Gordon, a finalist for the Golden Spikes Award.
We talk about your All-American taking charge. Right here is where Ryan Braun's really got to step it up, make something happen for his team.
They are not sure yet whether they're going to call that a sacrifice situation and Figueroa just moving to second on the fly ball, or whether they will allow him a stolen base.
Play was over. He's at first base. I'd make that just a... I would just call that an indifference play.
Well, you can't call a sacrifice unless a guy scores.
No, right. A sacrifice fly is only time from third to home. Stolen base, you got to at least be on the rubber. The pitcher's got to be on the rubber. That's a great thing. Let me know what the call is. That's interesting.
But it seems like you ought to award Danny something for making a play out of nothing.
I would say the one thing that would make most sense would be a stolen base.
I would, too. Official score still mulling that one over. That's simply not one you have to decide every game.
No.
2-2 now to Braun. Well, the Super Regionals already produced the all-time weirdest call last night. Arizona and Cal State Fullerton. On an intentional walk, a balk was called, and the winning run scored for the Titans. Scooped. Gordon not able to make the tag, but he does throw Brown out at first base. So Ryan Braun is out number two, and it was almost a double play. Gordon, according to the third base umpire down there, David Wiley, missed the tag on Danny Figueroa.
All I know is that Danny Figueroa just botched up everything positive he had going in. There's no way he should have, first of all, attempted to get to third base like he did, but it was a great heads-up job right there by Alex Gordon.
Good call. He missed
him. He missed him.
This is one of the few times you will hear Nebraska fans boo, although that call clearly was the correct one. By the time Gordon reached for Figueroa, he was by him by at least a foot or so. And while we think Anderson has been ejected, he has. Mike Anderson with the second situation in which he wanted an explanation here in the sixth inning, and they have thrown him out.
I don't know if they're throwing him out or Gordon out. Looks to me like Alex Gordon's been thrown out of the game. He's coming off the field.
Well, that would be just about as bizarre. That's a close enough play that you expect an argument if you're the umpire down there.
Something.
And you also have to expect that they're going to at least ask for a ruling. Well, here comes the end of the discussion.
I mean, Alex Gordon must have said something, because usually you will not go out a superstar player unless something was said. Just, and he didn't hesitate. Dave Wiley did not hesitate in throwing him out.
Jake Opitz is coming out of the Nebraska dugout. So let's watch it again. This is an attempted tag to start a double play by Gordon, who misses Figueroa. He does throw out Ryan Braun at first, but in the ensuing argument,
if he got
and they're
him,
also arguing that
he was out of the baseline. I mean, if he did get him, he just got him with his on the shirt, which is a tough call for the third base umpire right there. But you still have to get yourself in a position. Alex Gordon's got to realize that it's a 5-1 ball game. It's a close ball game. He's got to be careful what he says in that situation, because, as I mentioned earlier, he's your leader. And you know, that is just losing your composure just enough that you just hope it doesn't come back and haunt you as a team.
Wow. Alex Gordon, the Big 12 Player of the Year, with a two-run homer today, two walks, two runs scored, replaced by the freshman Jake Opitz down at third. And finally, now John Jay making his way to the box. All this with now two outs in the sixth inning, and Figueroa down at third base. Advancing on the fielder's choice.
I don't know what the college rule is, but there's a college rule where the player has to leave the field, or is he okay in the dugout?
Well, we just saw him in the dugout. Meanwhile, Rob Childress the Nebraska pitching coach out to the mound. Yeah, Gordon's still hanging around the dugout. He was due
to lead off,
the seventh inning for the Huskers. Now, this again was the ejection. It first looked as if it was going to be the head coach Anderson who got tossed.
That's some rabbit ears, too.
Yeah, Gordon
was about 15 feet away.
He wasn't even part of the conversation.
That was
but when he chipped in, suddenly he wasn't even part of the game anymore.
What he chipped in with was not necessary at that point.
Nor was it appreciated.
Yeah, there was no hesitation on Dave Wiley's part right there. Whatever he did say got his attention and got it quickly. And then John Jay comes in after Childress comes out and tries a two-out bunt.
One and one, Jay, responsible for the Hurricane run with his one-out solo shot in the fourth. Two and one, and Head Figueroa not taken second base. He'd still have been at first if you followed the way the inning has progressed. And that would have been a much more routine double play that Gordon tried to start, as this one is deep, but way foul. So Figueroa still at first. There is no tag attempt needed by Gordon. And he would have tried to start a 5-4-3 double play to end the inning.
The thing that's amazing is that as heads up as he was going from first to second, it was as boneheaded as his base running from second to third. But maybe it's a blessing in disguise because he got Alex Gordon out of the game.
Crowd on their feet as again Jay stays alive with a foul back to the screen. Just about as packed as you can get it here. Every seat, not just in the grandstand, but on the grass, circling the outfield. Full of the Big Red Nation again today. That is ripped on one hop to Ledbetter. So the sixth inning costs the Huskers their best player, but Johnny Dorn continues to work on a three-hitter. 5-1 headed to the seventh.
Still got game? She thinks your game is bingo. Ouch. New Stop Lines Moisturizer with SPF 15 from L'Oreal gives skin a younger, healthier look by reducing wrinkles in a month. New Stop Lines Moisturizer by L'Oreal Men's Expert, because you're worth it, too.
At Yellow Book, we looked at a lot of ideas to help you remember our name. We looked at blimps, a Yellow Book stadium. Sports marketing was a very appealing way to say Yellow Book has a lot of new fans. We even considered a line of Yellow Book clothing. Now that we're coast to coast, we've seen some pretty wild ideas. Some a little far out there. But at the end of the day, we think our book speaks for itself. So remember, yellowbook.com and Yellow Book, not the other book. 1-800-YB-YELLOW.
Today, you're a super painter with the amazing Wagner Wide Shot Power Painter. Fast and neat. It lets you paint up to 12 inches wide in one pass. The Power Painter. One of the ways Wagner gives you more power, because there's always something that needs painting. Wagner. Paint fast. Paint smart.
Well, we would have seen Alex Gordon moving to the plate to lead off the Husker seventh. Instead, after his ejection, he will watch as Jake Opitz will have the at-bat. And a different angle now of the conversation between Anderson and the umpire, David Wiley, as Gordon intrudes. And now is given the standing ovation as he leaves Hawks Field. If you were wondering, there is the college rule that after certain objections, you also have to sit out the next game. But that's when a fight is involved. And since that wasn't the case here, then should Nebraska win and go on to Omaha, there will not be any suspension served because of this ejection by Gordon.
Correct. But I'll tell you what, that was a very unusual inning all the way through. And I'll tell you what, whatever Alex said, it got Dave Wiley's attention because he didn't hesitate in throwing him out. And, guy that player, two-year player of the year, usually you give him a little room, but it must have been something that there was no hesitation involved.
Well, Gordon made his contribution with a two-run homer in the first, walked and scored in the third, and what turned into his final at bat, he also walked in the fourth. Opitz now, who's a .254 hitter, about 120 or so points behind Gordon. Three home runs, 14 runs batted in. Well, they let Gordon hang around for the rest of that inning, and now they had forced the rule that he must leave the dugout area following his ejection. Meanwhile, two balls and a strike. Opitz followed by Ledbetter and Gersh. Here's one of the many different approaches Order will take to his regular collection of deliveries. Fastball, curve, cut, change, but they can come from almost infinite arm angles. And Opitz, as Gordon did his last two times up, working a walk. Meanwhile, let's check in with Dave Refson.
Okay, Dave, Tennessee trying to eliminate number two national seed Georgia Tech. Michael Rivera, his first homer of the year. Remember Rob Fitzgerald, the unlikely hero yesterday. Rivera, the early hero today. But Georgia Tech, a great offensive team, so by no means out of it, down 4-0.
Both teams who have made appearances in Omaha the last few years. Curtis Ledbetter now, 0-for-3, reached on an error by Diaz last time up. Ricky Orta came on with one out and three runs in the third. He got an inning-ending double play. Since then, has allowed a lot of base runners. He just issued his third walk, but has not been touched for a hit yet. And a strike on the check swing, 0-2. Or strike three now, Ledbetter is the second strikeout victim of Ricky Orta. And again, let's hear from Dave Refson in the studio.
Okay, Dave, Clemson and number four national seed Baylor, and this is kind of the Bears' M.O. They do not overpower you offensively. Kevin Russo, a bunt single here, bringing home Paul Witt. Game one of this series, it's over on ESPNU right now. Baylor on top 2-1, top seven.
Great pitching staff there, too. Nebraska hitters say of all the pitchers they saw, there were so many excellent staffs in the Big 12. Baylor, in most of their opinions, had the best. And the Bear ace,
Mr. McCormick,
got a lot of rave reviews from the Huskers.
Big 12 is representing themselves pretty well
here. They really are. Later on today, Texas at Mississippi. Three of the Sweet 16, college baseball's version, out of the Big 12. Nebraska here, Baylor in Waco, Texas the only one traveling. They're in Oxford. 2-0 to Gersh. After the walk to Opitz, the strikeout of Ledbetter. Good afternoon for Andy. Doubled, singled, scored, and last time up, walked. So his postseason now, he's almost .500. Pop up here, shallow left center. And making the call is Danny Figueroa for out number two. Gersh retired for the first time today. So with Opitz still at first, now Daniel Bruce, the center fielder, who has struck out, walked. Last time a bunt fielder's choice. And he stole second, advanced to third on the throwing error by Eddie Rodriguez. A run and only three hits and two errors today for the Hurricanes. Five runs on six hits. No errors for the Cornhuskers. They have played an error-free Super Regional.
I'll tell you what, J.D. Arteaga is exactly right with Ricky Orta. He just, if he finds that arm slot, he's got tremendous stuff. It's just the consistency is what's causing his problems, and he's getting by. I tell you, I'd love to see what this kid can do when he just stays with one arm angle.
0-2. Coming into the spring, Orta battled with Chris Perez for the number three starting role. Danny Gill looked at as the closer at that point, freshman All-America. Season ended with Perez as the closer, having volunteered for that role. Orta in long relief again today. He has gone as long as seven innings earlier this year. There is Perez, ready to be Jim Morris's third pitcher of the afternoon. Pitch out, the throw back to first, and just diving in time is Opitz.
Pitch out, Opitz read it, play over first base. Good call. Danny Valencia a little upset there. Fans getting on him, throwing him out of the game. They figured if they threw Gordon out by saying something, maybe they could throw Valencia out, just making a look.
Little bit of an overreaction.
Heat of the battle. Heat of the battle. The facial means a lot. I was real bad at that, too. So I can understand where Valencia's coming from.
Many hard lessons
exactly.
In your past. The 2-2 is popped up. And a late break from left field by John Jay, who finally came on with a sprint to retire Bruce. Nebraska done in the seventh, still 5-1 stretch time in Lincoln.
Hammer throw is tough. It isn't just you against a 9-pound ball. It's you against yourself. It's pure concentration, and you have to dig deep inside to find every throw. It's brutal. I had to study biomedical engineering just to relax.
There are over 360,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us are going pro in something other than sports.
I'm ready to fight my cancer.
I'm ready to begin chemotherapy.
I really am ready because I'm going to take Neulasta right from the start to help protect me from infection.
Chemotherapy can reduce your white blood cell count and increase your risk of infection, which could put your treatment on hold. But Neulasta is a white blood cell booster that can help restore your white blood cell count to reduce your risk of infection. And with a sufficient white blood cell count, your doctor may have a better chance of giving you your chemo on schedule, which doctors agree is the first step to success. Neulasta is for most cancer patients receiving strong chemotherapy. In rare cases, splenic rupture or serious allergic reactions have been reported. Report abdominal or shoulder pain or any allergic reaction to your doctor immediately. The most common side effect of this injection is mild to moderate bone pain.
I'm ready to start.
I'm ready to fight.
I'm ready. Thanks to Neulasta.
Ask your doctor about Neulasta and how you can be ready for chemotherapy.
Our Diet Coke game track in the bottom of the seventh. 5-1 Huskers on their six hits, only three by the Hurricanes. Two errors, Johnny Dorn picking up where Jamba Chamberlain left off from his sparkling game one. Gordon ejected last inning, but it contributed a two-run homer. Cameron Deese, the starter for Miami, just 2 1/3 and responsible for all five of the Husker runs. Their offense limited to a 2.04 average and only a couple of solo home runs. Danny Valencia, Brendan Caton, Eddie Rodriguez here in the hurricane.
Dave Revson in the studio. We'll get you back out to Lincoln momentarily, but Clemson has taken the lead on Baylor, threatening for more. Let's check in now with Dave Sims and Nick Belmonte.
1-0. Let's send it back to our studio and Dave Revson.
Thank you, Dave. Very quickly now, we get you to Lincoln, Nebraska, one out away from its third ever trip to Omaha. Here's Dave Barnett.
The Nebraska Cornhuskers will go to Omaha for the third time in the last 5 years. Many scenes in college sports that match the dog pile for a victorious baseball team. Last out. Call strike three to Walter Diaz, and Brett Jensen saves his 15th of the year, an inning and two-thirds of perfect relief today to support freshman Johnny Dorn's 12th victory. Cornhuskers will take a 10-game winning streak to Rosenblatt Stadium. And they have made some believers, including a proud mother who watched her son, Johnny Dorn, last the first 6 1/3, almost matching the effort of ace Jabba Chamberlain yesterday. Smothering pitching, timely and at times powerful hitting, and perfect defense were the winning formula in this Lincoln Super Regional for the Nebraska Cornhuskers. They move on to their third College World Series. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Frank Viola and our entire ESPN crew, so long from Lincoln. From Dave Barnett, we go to Dave Revson in the studio.
Thank you, Dave. So the first ticket has been punched to Omaha. We have two series that haven't even begun yet, but Nebraska is headed to Omaha for just the third time ever, so there will be plenty of red in Omaha coming up this week.